Salutare, dragilor! Sunt tare fericită că pot să fiu acasă în România, prezentă de aici, din superbul Miami, cu ediții speciale, cu invitați extraordinari, inspiraționali de fiecare dată. Iar în seara aceasta am lângă mine o femeie superbă, o doamnă superbă, care a scris istorie în moda internațională în ultimii 20 de ani. Este vorba despre designerul Emma Saval și suntem la fabrica Emmei din Miami. Am hotărât să filmăm aici pentru că unde ar fi putut fi mai potrivit de atât? Iar Emma se află chiar aici lângă mine în seara aceasta. My next question, where do you, you know, what inspires you? Where do you think all this creativity comes, you know?
I think like the cutting edge of my run in this life is my personal evolution. So right now, for example, I brought another butterfly. In a quarter of a century, I'm launching a new butterfly, and that was a spiritual trip that I had. I don't know, elongate into that, but I was a blue butterfly in a black and red world of war. And I realized that if I could hold myself in fear and anger, I became black and red and they wouldn't see me, so I could pass safe. And then I realized that I've been playing a little bit safe lately, so I should actually have a quantum jump. So that is where the butterfly comes in, and I know where I'm going. But we in Albania don't talk about where we're going until we go, because it's kind of a curse. It doesn't happen, so yeah. But I'm in the process.
I've heard about that. So you think it's true? If you talk about your plans?
If I think like energetically, it's not that it's true, but if I speak it once, if I speak it twice, if I speak it three times, I flatten my excitement. And I do that by depending on what the other person will say, because I'm using them as mirrors to my belief.
And we all do.
If that mirror of belief is not holding me up to excitement and trust, and I might flatten my energy. You know, so if I tell somebody, oh my God, I'm going to create this and this, and the person is like, yeah, but you can't. And if you do it, you shouldn't. And your energy goes like, So when you are inspired, when you have inspiration inside you, you hold it in there until creation, because you might flatten it and doesn't have enough momentum to come into creation.
That is an amazing advice.
There is many system in place. You can have the other system, because I said it to everybody. Now I better do it because I look like,
right?
Because I look like I will jump in that system too.
But you also manifest it kind of when you're saying I'm doing this or I already did this or right?
Yeah. Totally. We in Albania have a word. It's called BESA, BESA, which is the word. In my culture, when you give the word, you keep your word. Like, we are handled by our word, how well you keep the word. And I use that all the time. I give my word, I don't want to do it. I so don't want to do it, but I gave my word, so I can do it. So this is another system, you know, as you say something, to actually do it just because you said it.
Yeah. So what are the meanings of your designs?
It's my personal evolution, and it's the cutting edge of my next evolution. So right now I've discovered I'm not a very good receiver, for example. I've created this artwork, The Codes of Receiving, and I shot it in Mississippi with cotton fields. And it's like the tree of life with cotton fields. Somehow, when I was talking about receiving energy, that's how I look at it. Like the cotton and the tree of the life and the whole design. I should wear the dress and I should praise the creativity of it. It's been 6 years I've created, I still have not. I wasn't ready to learn how to receive. You know, that is how I look at it, because I'm still not a great receiver.
You're and a giver.
I love to give, you know, and when it comes time to receive, I don't even have time to do it, so I go and give some more. Because things are always coming, you're just like not allowing that. I think to receive, it has to be like a pose to have gratitude. You know, it's like the gratitude is like a magnetic energy, it receives. And love is like an electric energy, it gives. So I have to sit more into my magnetic energy so I can receive.
I have so many questions in my head, and you know, and then this question goes, and then this comes. So how important is it energy-wise, what we wear, color, fabric, what does that do to us?
I believe it's very important. If it wasn't that important, the athletes will not wear the same sock or the same thing over and over so they can
win. Right?
Listen, it's very important. Like, look at the dresses like amulets. Everything you wear has an energy, and that energy is imbued into you, and you vibrate it and you attract realities through that. And that is why some paintings called millions of dollars, but why? Well, that's the reason, because energy has a value, and that value is very important. Example, the paint that we use, it's a resin, and it comes transparent. We put in there the pigment, we put the metallic sheen, we put the glitter, whatever you see, it's put inside. Every time we create our paint, here is like a spiritual ceremony, because it's liquid. So whatever we put, and then we'll shave metal inside, we'll have incense everywhere, we'll drink tea, we'll praise, we'll have beautiful music. So the paint is imbued with the codes of love or gratitude or whatever we would like to be, because that's what I am, that's what my ladies are here. Like, we live it for real. It's not that we're just like saying it. It's what we do.
They say that we attract our tribe, right?
Yeah, so absolutely.
Then
yeah.
How did you find the wonderful ladies to, you know, connect, and how did you know that they're into the same spiritual beliefs as you are?
Because we're always on search. If I have like an amazing lady with all mine are, we tell them, if you find somebody like you, bring her here. That is, so we're constant search. It's like somebody that is amazing, he's like, do you have a friend just like you? Bring her in. Because keep in mind, I'm teaching the girls here everything. I don't need them to be seamstresses. I don't need them to be painters.
You teach them
everything, all, right? Everything. We give a profession here, and I love to do it. Like, teaching is my...
I know, it's one of your passions, yeah, right?
I love to teach. Love, love, love.
So I think that you probably even prefer for people to not come basically broken from other places, yeah, and just start fresh here, right?
Well,
I would imagine.
I think so. Now, I have to give you an example. So my brother is a volleyball coach in California, for very talented. I sent my son to him for 2 years. I wanted to start my son in volleyball. And my son was older, was 14 years old, never played volleyball. He was a rower, he was a swimmer. And my brother got him at 14 years old, which is pretty late. Today he's national champion of America and North America.
Congratulations.
And my brother, thank you so much. And my brother said, you know what? It was so important that he was innocent. At 14 years old, I touched him for the first time. Nobody had touched him. So the technique, everything he taught, like, he was open, he was innocent. So I do believe that, for sure.
So he was an athlete, but he wasn't already tired of it.
Yeah, he wasn't tired, right? And he hadn't learned it wrong.
Yeah,
he just didn't know it. So when you learn something wrong, you have to undo the wrong. It's like when you get older, you want to change something. It's very hard to change it because you have to break the old pattern. And when you're young, you learn everything easily because you're open, you're free.
And how do you mix this huge creativity that you have with business? How does that go together?
I'm a right brainer. I'm like a heart person.
You're
I'm not a brain person, and I feel a lot. So I have discovered a method that shows me the signs I should follow blindly. Like, sometimes I do something, I'm like, ooh, I can't believe I'm doing this. God knows what's going to happen. But inside me, I've seen the light, and the light looks like, like, the signs that I follow looks like an excitement. It's like I see something and then I feel this rush of excitement or goosebumps, and I'm like, that's the way. And it's sometimes like, I can't believe I'm doing this, but that's the way. I'm following my excitement. I was an adrenaline junkie when I was very young. So since I cannot like throw myself out of an airplane because I'm important right now, many people depend on me, I need that excitement, that little adrenaline of doing something that I have not done before.
So I wanted to ask you something, but we jumped forward. So before you moved to the United States, you had 1 year where you traveled the whole yeah. world to discover yourself, to discover what you love. It was kind yeah. of a eat, pray, love moment.
Yeah. Well, I read the signs because I've never done that. And the sign was I hurt my shoulder in a freak accident because it didn't make sense at all how I hurt myself. I'm taking a year off because I can't play volleyball and I'll be too sad to do anything else. So I'll distract myself with traveling. My fiancé at the time was a big traveler. He spoke 7 languages. I love traveling. So we kind of backpack, you know, we'll go work for a little bit, a week or so, and then travel for another month or so. And so it was reading the signs. It expanded my mind. And we love to go to museums and art exhibitions and everything that had to do with art. So it looks like before I created Emma Saval, the universe or the creation wanted to imbue in me this art to go to Paris and see all the churches or go to Rome or go to Sicily. Like I absorbed a huge amount of art and beauty before I made it to Miami
and
to start
the journey,
Emma Saval.
Right?
It was a journey, you know.
And you ended up in Miami.
I ended up in Miami.
And you were home, right? You felt it?
Immediately. Like the air of the city, the humidity. I'm like an orchid. I need humidity. It's like I love it. I love the heat. I love the cosmopolitan nature of the city. I love how we don't judge. We're not judging city. Nobody judges you. I don't know if you girls have noticed it.
Because it's very intercultural.
It's so complex in such a way that you just spill into becoming your true self. It's like almost a therapeutic city. It's a therapy to come here.
Was it difficult to make it in America?
Because I believe that I attract my own vibrations, I don't like anything easy. I don't know for what reason. I give myself a really raw life. So I grind quite a bit, but I achieve. And I grind and I achieve some more. So that is, I'm not saying it was easy, but it was very exciting. Like I haven't had a dull moment in this city. It has been.
You were very passionate
yeah.
about what you were doing,
yeah.
so we probably
yeah.
never felt
yeah.
like work.
But even
now, you're now working from the morning until the night, yeah. non-stop.
Yeah. Because this place is like a hub. Everybody comes here. There is always creativity. Everything, something happened. And at 5 o'clock, I have to run my business. Oh my God, I didn't do anything. So my real work is when everybody leaves, that I put the drawings together, I prepare my team for next day.
So what advice do you have for someone who moves to the States and wants to make it in the fashion industry?
It has changed a lot from the times I came here.
And not only fashion, like, you know, to make, like to adapt and to, what would be the first thing you would tell them about the States?
A lot of people will not believe me saying this, but I've got to say it because I'm the proof of it, is when you own what you are, what you have come here to do, the path is a lot easier. And as a methodologist that I am, like that I understand energetically how to achieve it, is you have come here with a purpose. And when you are giving your purpose, there is an inner joy. And when there is an inner joy, you attract the people that have the same inner joy. And when you are together, like we are, things unfold faster. So it is a lot easier if we could actually let our mind tell us, like stop telling the old story, to allow for miracles to unfold. You know, that's telling yourself the whole story, it's what stops the real miracle. And it should be so easy. Just do nothing. So what do you mean do nothing? Do nothing. Allow allow life to flow through you. You know? And that's why I love being with artists, because it flows easily, you know? It's like they are like a vessel. They are not a vessel for energy, for life to flush through them, as opposed to trying to calculate everything. And
So besides the whole creativity and spirituality, you actually own a really serious, successful business.
I know.
And you've been also awarded by the industry. so many times. I'll just mention a few. The Breakout Award for the Best New Fashion Designer in Paris in 2000. Best Fashion Designer by New Times, Best of Miami. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
How important is it to be recognized by the industry in order to be a successful designer?
I'm sure it's very important. I don't have that excitement of being recognized. I think communism destroys it somehow, that I wish I could appreciate it so much more. I don't know, like communism is a plague, is not a system. So for people that don't know, and I somehow don't have the joy I should have for being recognized, as if I'm scared of like, don't recognize me, something bad might happen. Imagine with all the work I've done, how hard it is to take out of me that fear of not trying to be good because others get jealous, because that's what communism truly is. Well, now more than ever is very important because of social media, all of that, you do need to prove yourself, because there's not a brick and mortar anymore, like the reputation, you don't know what the brand is coming from, what it's doing. So being recognized, it gives you that title that people can trust you.
Yeah, but in the same time, with the online world, it just gave, I think, every artist the opportunity of doing it by themselves.
Yes.
You don't really depend on the industry. Of course, it's nice to be awarded, but yeah maybe.
But even in the social media, you need the awards. Like the website developer asked me to put some testimonies in my website, and I was like, no, it looks too commercial. He said, trust me. Mm-hmm. So I asked my clients to send it. I only put 5. It was amazing, the quantum jump of transaction that the people that were visiting that vault as opposed to before. Because they needed that testimonial, like, this is a good brand, I've been buying them for years, and these people like have amazing product. It was so important to have
they,
it.
They are amazing, and people should know more about it. But in the same time, you attract your tribe, as you said it.
Yeah.
So you dressed a lot of celebrities, among Katy Perry, Jennifer Lopez,
Paris Hilton. Rosalind Sanchez, Paula Abdul, Lil Kim. I don't have a TV, I should know more, but...
We're all obsessed with celebrities, right?
Yeah.
So how was it to work with them?
Well, you don't work with them, you know. They have stylists, and stylists contact us, and it's like a process of working with the artist of the artist, that has a vision of the artist should be looking like. And then some of them just resonate with you. And I resonated with a lot of these artists. It wasn't that I had a marketing company or not. They found my clothes in stores and contacted us.
You say that every woman is an individual work of art who deserves to be framed in an equally original work of art. What kind of woman are you creating for?
For a goddess, like truly, I can see like this blooming woman with like nurturing energy, ownership, love, connectivity, community. It's like it's so needed right now. Like rise, women, whenever you are, because we are going to save this world. You know, it's like that's what we're missing. Or let's say that is what we're evolving into, because we don't miss anything, but it's like our new evolution where we're growing. I feel like the feminine energy needs to rise. It's time. So I have this collection. I created it about 7 years ago, and I was going through a spiritual ceremony, and it came to me like the queen is awake, as if we have been like asleep for a little while. And for the first time, we understand our own power, our responsibility to this world, to our children. You know, so every collection for me has been like a warrior princess or a dreamer. Like I have touched all the facets of the feminine blooming and beauty. And I keep doing it one by one, but I think right now is the goddess time.
Yeah. I am so happy that I'm wearing this dress because I totally understand what you're saying. I do feel like a goddess in this dress. Like, I feel the energy. I feel so beautiful in it. It's just the perfect little green. I don't think I've ever worn green before, but it does. I do feel the energy. So what is this exactly?
So that artwork is called the Sacred Codes. For spiritual people, I don't know if you understand my language, but is the codes of the next dimension. So let's see if this reality was a holographic reality, and this is the game we're playing. That's the codes of the new game. And if this game is a victim mentality, that things are happening to us, and we have to support life, and we have to carry life, and we have to suffer life, we move to that reality, and that's the grid, when you were creators. And ownership of your existence, ownership of everybody you meet in your life, knowing that everybody you meet is a version of you. And actually, it's the version of you you need to put attention at this moment, because you kind of meet your wound. You meet what you need to heal. So every person that triggers you is actually the person that the angel that's coming at the moment to trigger you on that little thing that you need to evolve and bring from ignorance to knowledge, or from dark to light. And that is how the process of evolution, of blooming of our existence happens over and over.
So I guess that this dress is not by chance on me. We're probably, like you choose what you need,
that.
Right?
Yeah. Always. This, always. I've seen this over and over. That women that come throughout here, that's why I'm saying it's a hub. One woman comes, another woman comes, and then somehow they go like, you know, they become friends forever. All my clients are friends with each other. They're like, something happens. So
Goddesses.
There is nobody that comes here randomly. I have never seen anybody coming here that's not coming from something and going to something much bigger. It's like, if you're coming by here, you're ready for a quantum jump. That's why you're doing
God
it.
God help us. So with so much success and achievement, is there something that you haven't done that you still aspire to do?
Okay, I have to add this for everybody else that's out there, an artist or something. Success and achievement, the fraud syndrome never goes away. I forget for a moment that I feel like a fraud. I was like, oh my God, I have achieved nothing. So for everybody that's feeling the same, it doesn't matter how much I achieve, how
it
far I go.
Right?
You always have that thing inside me, I'm not good enough. And I think rather than being fearful of it, we should look at it like that code that tells you grow. But then internally tell yourself the story that it's okay to feel like that. You have achieved a lot. What you say inside you're not good enough is because you need to grow constantly, but it's not to put you down. So yeah, what I haven't done yet, a lot. Yeah, I have plans, like as I age, what I'm gonna do at this age, what I'm gonna do at that age. I think because I always had this plan, I've so looked forward to aging, really. I've never been fearful of it, because I have plans. When I go this age, from this age, I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna do that, so yeah.
I don't think that goddesses are afraid to get old.
Yeah, not at all. I'm like so excited to see my son growing. I'm going to have grandchildren. Oh my God,
exactly.
I can't wait for it. Yeah.
So what's next for the Emma Saval brand? And I know that Miami Fashion Week is coming, and you also have a surprise for the Romanian people, but we'll talk about that after you tell us your plans here.
Yes. So I'm doing Miami Fashion Week. I'm the opening designer of the whole event.
Ooh,
and I'm having down 12 goddesses, each one carrying particular codes of the creation of the different artworks I've created. So I'm doing it as a couture brand that I am. Even though I do bathing suits, my business is a couture. So I'm having like very big, beautiful, grandiose over pieces. To show the goddess quality of the lady, the beauty walking, and then there is a bathing suit underneath They're all coded.
We can't wait to see them.
Yeah, and I think the artwork I'm using this year is like, I'm making my paint translucent. So it's going to be like the glass in the church.
Oh.
So I'm going to create all these designs. Hopefully that's it, because I'm still in the creation. And very excited, very, very excited.
Well, we are excited. And tell us about the trunk show that is going to happen in Romania.
Well, because I have so many Romanian clients.
Romani.
And thank you so much for
Romanian
loving me.
Goddesses.
I appreciate totally Romanian goddesses. One of my friends has invited me in August, said that it's a good time to come, and I'd love to. So we'll do a trunk show. We're studying like more or less what Romanian likes, because I have all the dresses that have been bought over time. So I'll create like a beautiful collection, and I'll make sure that we'll offer something unseen before.
That is so amazing. I will be there at the trunk show. I'll
I'm
be
looking
in
forward.
Romania in August, and it will happen in Bucharest. So where can people, where will they be able to find out about the trunk show? On your Instagram page, on your Facebook?
So yes, we'll post it on our Instagram page. I'm hoping you can post it on yours as
of
well.
Of course.
And then my girlfriend that is organizing there will post it on her. So you will know for sure. Yeah.
That is amazing. So what is the Instagram? I mean, I'm following you, but I want you to say the Instagram page where people can find you.
Okay, so my Instagram page is Emma, E-M-A. Saval is S-A-V, like Victory, A-H-L. Emma
Saval. Yeah, we'll have
Saval.
It down there.
Yeah.
And where can the Romanian goddesses find your dresses? Can they buy them online as well?
Yes, or? Online, emmasaval.com, yeah.
So mm-hmm. you ship it to
We
Romania.
Ship worldwide, because that was my business for the last 27 years.
Oh, so there you go,
yeah,
girls.
Yeah, yeah, I shipped, we were an international company.
But at the trunk show, they will be able to see them there.
They can see them, they can try, we'll have people to do the measurements if they want to order it later on. As I said, we have clients worldwide. So once I'll have the measurements, they can order them, they can change colors, they can do, we create with our clients. Like, we're offering something that does not exist in the industry right now. And we're offering it because we create our own fabrics. And other companies cannot do it, they have to buy the fabric. Because we create our own fabric, you can come to us and ask any measurements you want, every color, every texture, every way we serve.
Every message.
Every message.
That is so amazing.
I think, like, if you had asked me about, like, what is the mission of my company, it was going to be, like, we are in service. Like, these dresses are not competing with a goddess. These dresses are in service. These dresses make her look beautiful, allow her to be comfortable, allow her to feel that she belongs, that she's in the right place at the right time, because they're so artistic. You cannot say this dress is out of trend. They're classy, they're sexy, they're
artistic.
This is
forever.
It's forever.
As long as I will fit in it.
Yeah. I went through all the needs that a woman has, and over the years, I've fulfilled them all, one by one. It's comfort, easy to care, easy to travel, messages, the coloring. I have covered it all. It's taken me a quarter of a century, but I can say that we have come pretty far.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for this
beautiful interview.
Your brand is one of a kind, because you are one of a kind.
Thank you.
And we need
like
more
are you?
Women
thank
like you.
Thank you so much.
Do you have a message for the Romanian goddesses?
I love that, the Romanian goddesses. It might look cliche, but I will say ownership of what you are. And it doesn't matter how you get to that, because you can get to that through systems like human design, for example, or other tests, or you can get through that just self-absorbing, but there is nothing out there. Everything is within. Like, everything that you see is a projection from your own existence. Like, focus on you, love you, don't project anything out. Me, love yourself over and over, take care, help yourself, like, become aware of what makes you happy, what it doesn't, and apply it, because when you love you and you're good with you, you project it to the whole creation, and the creation mirrors you back. So yeah, that is ownership.
Emma, thank you so, so much. This is the most wonderful interview. I couldn't be more grateful. Mm. And your brand is amazing because you are one of a kind. And you put all your love and passion in it. And we need more women like you to talk on TV.
I have many friends like me.
Because, yes,
I can bring them in. Romanians too.
Yes, yes, yes.
Beautiful.
And you have to go to Romania and actually make
I'm so looking
hubs
forward. so looking forward to have some Romanian love. You guys are very loving, just like us. We're the same. Beautiful.
I know you are very loving. So thank you, and
thank
I can't wait
you.
To see you for many more coffees and many more
yes.
fittings with your gorgeous dresses, and in Romania for the trunk show in Bucharest.
Looking forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Vă mulțumesc tare mult că ați stat alături de noi. Ne vedem duminica viitoare la ora 8. Vă iubesc și seara minunată.
Mua!
Yay! Thank you. Awesome.